Sergeant Preston of the Northwest Mounted Police with Yukon King, swiftest and strongest lead dog breaking the trail in the relentless pursuit of lawbreakers in the wild days of the Yukon. Back to the days of the gold rush as Sergeant Preston with his wonder dog Yukon King meets the challenge of the Yukon. This is the Yukon, the territory patrolled by Sergeant Preston. In summer, the land of unending day, where toiling men grub in the eerie light of the midnight sun and dream of the rainbow's end. Gordon Landing on Lake Janet. Summer, goal of many a weary chechako.
What is it, Mary?
It's a canoe. Someone's coming. No, it's two people. Oh, now I'll have someone to talk to. I hope they can talk about something other than trapping for a change.
Now, now. Who else do you think would come to our out-of-the-way place, Mary? But for your sake, I hope so, too. I suppose it does get awfully lonesome here for a pretty girl.
Oh, now, Pop, I love this, and you too. They look like chechakos.
Yep, they're tenderfeet. They sure don't know anything about handling a canoe.
Oh, now I'll have someone to talk to. Maybe they'll have news from the States. Maybe even a newspaper. Oh, Paul.
Forgotten.
Did you really think I would? You, all the way up here.
Oh, Jim, I want you to meet my partner, Pete Logan. Pete and I have been together for a long time.
Hey, Pete?
Old friends? Oh, Dad, that's wonderful.
Please go back to the house, Mary.
Oh, so this is Mary. You know, the last time I saw you, your mother was carrying you in her arms. How is Clara, Jim?
Clara passed away almost 10 years ago.
And you never let me know, Jim.
I told you to go back up to the house, Mary.
Your father's being very rude, Mary. Now, if you won't tell her who I am, I will.
Mary, this is your uncle, my brother Harry.
But, Dad, you told me Uncle Harry was dead.
Hardly.
You know why we thought it best to tell Mary that.
I made a mistake, spent some time in prison, and disgraced your loving dad. And our highly respectable family thought it best to forget that I ever existed.
Dad, are you sure it's true?
Of course it's true. Why else would I give up a good home, a good job in Toronto?
Well, I didn't expect to be welcomed with open arms, but a reception like this, and from my own brother. Put the stuff back, Pete. We're getting out of here.
What?
No, wait. Oh, Pop, you mustn't send them away.
I guess you're right, Mary. We'll put them up for a few days, give them a chance to get located elsewhere.
Half a loaf is better than none.
It would never work out your staying here. I hold a position of trust with the folks here, sometimes have to act as confidant, even banker. If they should ever find out about your record...
Come on, this stuff's getting awful heavy.
Show them where they're to bunk, Mary. Now, don't get any ideas, Harry. I'm only doing this for Mary's sake. She'd never understand if I threw you out, as I should.
All I want is a chance for a fresh start.
If you're wise, you'll keep straight this time. This is Mountie territory.
Come on, Harry. I'm getting tired of all this palaver.
I'm afraid you'll find the bunkhouse rather primitive, Uncle Harry, but it's the best we have to offer you.
Any bed with a roof over it would look mighty good right now.
Mm-hmm. What is it now?
Isn't it dangerous having all that money and gold around?
It hasn't been, up to now.
Well, that's what I came in to talk to you about.
If this is the preliminary to a touch, Harry, I might as well set you straight right now. None of what you saw in that safe is mine. It belongs to the miners around here. A sacred trust. Mary and I have very little ourselves. We're barely getting along.
Still the same old Jim, huh? Now, why can't you understand that everything isn't either always black or white?
According to my reckoning, a man's either honest or he's not. There's no in-between.
Well, there is repentance, Jim. And I want you to believe that I've learned my lesson. That's why I'm here now, privately.
You're my brother, Harry. Goodness knows I want to believe you.
Then why not try taking me at face value? I'm trying to make up for past mistakes, Jim. Thanks, Jim. It's going to be all right, Pete.
So you and good old Jim bury the hatchet.
Well, what do you want me to do? Break down and cry?
Oh, better than that. I just stumbled onto a fortune.
Where?
Bags of dust, stacks of coin, and rolls of bills, all in Jim's safe.
What kind of a safe is it?
Well, it's not going to be easy. But I think I can get the combination out of Jim. Or Mary.
Well, what are we waiting for?
For the right moment. This time, we'll play it cute. I don't hanker for another prison stretch. Get back.
Well, come in, come in. Welcome to our palace.
Harry, this is your bed clothing. Oh, Charlie, just put those on the upper bunk. I asked Charlie if you might stay with him. This is rightfully his cabin, and, well, he works for Pop. Oh, Charlie, this is my Uncle Harry and his friend, Mr. Logan.
Howdy.
Pop told me about the talk you had with him. I'm so happy that you patched up things between you.
So am I, Mary. Family quarrels are pointless.
Well, if you could only stay on with him now. He needs company. And he could use someone to help him, well, when the trading gets busy. Someone like you, his own brother, whom he can trust.
Well, I'll have a talk with him about it, huh?
Well, I better hurry with dinner or we'll never eat. And I made a special dessert to celebrate everything. You promise to talk to him?
I promise. Word of honor.
Sit down, Mary, and finish your dinner.
You won't forget your promise, Uncle Harry.
Promise about what?
Well, Mary made me promise to discuss our future plans, Jim.
You have something in mind?
Well, Pete and I talked it over, and we thought we'd like to do a little prospecting. That is, of course, if you could help out.
You know my financial situation, Harry. As I told you, we have very little.
Well, of course, we'd cut you in on anything we'd find. Wouldn't we, Pete?
Sure. Anything that's right.
Gee, that sounds wonderful. And you'd be with us all the time.
Well, maybe I could work out a small grubstake for you, Harry.
Thanks.
Sergeant Preston and King, come in.
Hello, Mary.
Have you eaten yet, Sergeant?
Yes, I have. Thank you.
Then you're just in time for pie and coffee.
Oh, I can never resist your pie, Mary. Hello, Jim.
Sergeant.
Oh, Jim, Pete and I better be running along. We have to get our stuff together.
Wait a while, Harry. I want you to meet our friend, Sergeant Preston. Sergeant, this is my brother, Harry, and his partner, Pete Logan. Come on, sit down, Sergeant.
Hi, hello.
Sit down, man.
I'll bring your cup right in, Sergeant. Come on, big boy. I have a big bone for you out in the kitchen.
Go on, King. Go with Mary. It's all right.
Aren't you about 2 weeks early on this patrol, Sergeant?
Yes, I am. I'm looking for a couple of murderers, Jim. Thought you might be able to help me.
I have another pie baking in the oven, Sergeant. It'll be ready shortly. Why, is something wrong?
I was telling your dad, Mary. Somebody murdered poor old Moose Benson in Whitehorse.
Oh, no. Who'd want to kill a harmless old trapper like him? You remember him, Poppy used to come here to trade.
Moose had just sold his winter catcher furs. Was celebrating with a couple of men he met in Whitehorse. Found his body the next morning, pockets empty behind the Pawnee Cafe.
Well, it's too bad you didn't get a description of the thieves, Sergeant.
Oh, dear, the pie.
I did, Mr. Carver. Notch Davis, who owns the cafe, gave me a good description of both men. Davis also said he heard one of the men say that they were from Toronto. That's your hometown, isn't it, Jim? Thanks, Murray.
Why, yes, but it's a big place. I'm not likely to know the men you want.
Well, I traced the men to Gordon Landing. They made inquiry there about the way to Carver's trading post on Lake Janet.
Well, look here, if you're inferring that we had a...
There must be some mistake.
Dad.
If you're innocent, you have nothing to fear. On your feet, hands behind you. I'm arresting you on suspicion for the robbery and murder of Moose Benson.
Sergeant, there must be some mistake.
Drop that gun.
Now, clear out, both of you.
You mean you're going to let us go?
I said clear out before I change my mind.
Come on, Pete, let's go.
Not go after them tonight, Sergeant. You just took a nasty blow on the head.
You let them get away? Where's King making all that noise?
He's out in the woodshed with a bone.
Let him out, will you, Mary? It's too bad King wasn't here. He wouldn't have escaped so easily.
Are you all right, Sergeant?
I know you'd have helped old fella if you'd been able.
Before you go, there's something I'd better tell you.
What's that, Jim?
I could have stopped them, Sergeant, but I let them go.
But why?
My own brother. I've never lifted a finger before to help him. Maybe it wouldn't be so bad if I had.
Oh, Pa.
Now I suppose you're going to arrest me, Sergeant.
We'll talk about that later. In any case, they can't get far. I think I know where I can intercept them if I hurry. I hope you never have to regret what you've done, Jim.
Sergeant Preston rode around Lake Janet looking for Pete and Harry. Preston knew the smooth waters of the lake gave them their best chance for quick escape. But the two clever crooks did not remain on the lake's surface very long. They had another plan. A plan to fool Preston and make considerable profit for themselves.
Pop and go to bed. There's nothing you can do.
All right, honey. I guess you're right. I'll be in soon. I'm turning in, Charlie. You better turn in, too.
Great spirit rest you.
Keep quiet. You won't get hurt. Inside, quick. Come on.
All right, Indian, into bed with you. And no funny business. Tie him up while I get our stuff together. Well, I see we're still riding our luck. Moose's money is still here. Let's finish the job.
Aren't we going to take our stuff with us?
We'll come back for it after you crack that safe. I sure like to see Preston's face when he finds out how we doubled back and tricked him. Come on.
Is that you?
Hello, Jim.
Harry, what are you doing back here?
Pete wanted to have a try at your safe.
So this is the thanks I get for helping you escape.
I have to laugh every time I think of that, Molly. We sure led him a merry chase, huh?
Why don't we get the combination out of him? It'll save time.
That's a good idea. What is it, Jim?
It's not my money, Harry. I'm not telling you.
Don't try my patience, Jim.
No.
I'm running out of brotherly love, Jim.
No, you'll have to kill me first.
Well, maybe I will.
Oh. How could you do this, your own brother?
Well, we've covered the lake from every angle, King, and they're not on it. Must have beached the canoe and started overland. Find the canoe, fella. Find the canoe so we can pick up the trail.
Don't, Kenny McKinney, don't!
Then why don't you tell us what the combination
is? I don't know it. I told you I didn't know it.
Mary's telling the truth, Harry. She doesn't know it.
Then maybe you'd better, or I'll let...
Wait a minute, Harry. How would you like to save your father further trouble, huh?
Anything.
All right. And tell us where he keeps his blasting powder.
No, don't tell them, Mary.
You do know where it is. I thought you'd have some around a trading post. Time's running out, Mary. We're going to open that safe one way or the other.
Oh, Pop, listen.
If you know what's good for you, you'll take your blood money and get out.
It's up to you, Mary, whether we do this the hard way or not.
Blasting powder's kept out back. I'll show you where.
No, Mary, don't. We have no guarantee they won't kill us after they get what they want.
Jim, I'm your brother. I give you my word.
Your word. Preston was right. He knew I'd regret letting you go.
You were fool enough to tell him?
Yes, Harry. I'm a fool.
Let's go, Mary.
No!
Their canoe, all right, King. Good work, boy. Strange place to ditch it, though, unless... You know, King, I think they fooled us. I think they backtrailed on us. Come on. Our waterway can be at Jim's place in a half an hour.
Why do we have to drag this outside? Why don't we just blow it here?
Because it's safer for us. Suppose this place caught fire.
Where's Mary? What have you done with her?
Now, take it easy, Jim. She's safe enough. She's locked in the closet off the kitchen. Come on. Careful of that stuff, Pete. You'll blow us to kingdom come.
Don't worry. I haven't blown myself up yet. You're talking to an expert.
Mr. Jim, you all right?
Johnny, quick, cut me loose. Get a knife out of stock.
All right, let's go.
That was a blast, not a gunshot.
What did I tell you, Pete?
Now to finish the job up, get some grub, and we're off.
Too late, Charlie. They'll kill you. Run for help.
Stay where you are, Indian.
Why don't I just plug him now and get it over with, huh?
No, I got a better idea. He's going to earn his salt guiding us to the border.
No.
Oh, let me plug him now, Harry.
You go out to the kitchen and have Mary rustle us up some food. I'll take care of Mr. Indian here. You're wasting time, Indian. Your last chance.
Do as he says, Charlie. No one will blame you.
You pay me for guide.
Now you're talking sense.
Need plenty supplies. Border him far.
All right. I won't repeat my mistake. This time, I'm holding you for Preston.
Nice work, Jim, but you've forgotten one thing.
You can't bluff me, Harry.
I'm not bluffing, Jim.
Hey, Pete!
Yeah?
Hold the girl, Pete.
I'll manage in here.
I got her.
You forgot about Mary, didn't you, Jim? I'll take the gun now.
Mr. Jim, I take rifle, go outside, get other man from window.
Thanks, Charlie, but I can't risk it with Mary in there.
Your hospitality, Jim. Mary, you sure know how to treat your relatives.
All right, come on, let's go.
You won't hurt Charlie. You'll let him go when you reach the border.
No, Mary, we wouldn't hurt poor old Charlie. Come
on. All right, hands high. You're under arrest.
Hands behind you. And no more tricks. King knows them all.
My hands!
We'll attend to that later. Inside, both of you. Come on, get in there. Come on, King.
I can see now how bad Harry really is. I was very foolish.
Yes, the best thing to do always is to let the law take its course.
We're very grateful to you, Sergeant. And King is certainly a member of the force.
Yes, he is. And so is Rex, who's patiently waiting for me to pick him up. And after that, Jim, I'm afraid you're going to have to go with me.
I expected that, Sergeant. I'm ready to take my medicine.
Oh, you're not going to arrest him, Sergeant. What he did was without thinking, but, well, he's paid enough for it.
Who said anything about arrest, Mary? I need your dad for a material witness. He'll be back before the week's over.
Oh, Sergeant.
Well, King, this case is closed.